Let's see how to solve a recurrence relation. So we were seeing this code earlier in the previous lecture. The recurrence relation for this was Tn is equals to Tn by 2 plus 1. And the base case was T1 equals to 1. A base case is very important while we are solving a recurrence relation. There is no unique method which can solve all the recurrence relation, but we will see few methods using which it is easier to solve this recurrence relation. There are basically three methods which we are going to study. Number one is forward substitution. Number second is backward substitution. And number third is master's method. So if we see the first one, forward substitution, let's take an example and try to solve using forward substitution. Let's say Tn is equals to Tn minus 1 plus n. And the base case is T1 equals to 1. So how to solve using forward substitution? What you need to do is, you need to start with the base case and try building till the n. So we are giving T1 equals to 1. Okay. And the equation is given is Tn equals to Tn minus 1 plus n. So what we are going to do, we are going to put on the right hand side the value which is known to us. We know T1. So we are going to put T1 here plus we will see what. So if this is T1, it means n minus 1 equals to 1. It means n equals to 2. So this is going to be T2 equals to T1 plus 2. Okay. So we know the value of T1. The value of T1 is 1. Let's substitute it. We'll not add this right here. Let us put it right there. Now what we will put? We will put on the right hand side the new term which we know. We know T2. So now n minus 1 is equals to 2. So n equals to 3. So this will become T3 and this will be plus 3. And if we put the value of T2 as it is, it will become 1 plus 2 plus 3. Now again we will do the same thing. We will put on the right hand side the value which we know. We know T3. So now n minus 1 is equals to 3. So n equals to 4. So this will become T4 equals to T3 plus 4. The value of T3 is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Now this is the value of T4. And if we see the pattern, if it was T1, it was only 1. If it was T2, it was 1 plus 2. T3 was 1 plus 2 plus 3. T4 was 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So similarly, Tn will become 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus up to n. Now there is no term which is in form of t here, right? On the right hand side, there is no term which is of the form t. Now we can directly solve this. So this is a summation of I equals to 1 to n I. And the formula of this is, because this is sum of n natural number, the formula is n into n plus 1 by 2. So the time complexity or Tn is equals to n square plus n by 2 or big O of n square, right? And what it is saying basically, if we see this equation also, this is saying that the time complexity of n depends on the time complexity of n minus 1 after doing n operation. So at every step I am doing n operation. So if I do n operation, next time I am doing n minus 1 operation, then n minus 2 operation. Like this if I am doing, then the sum is of course n square. Although forward substitution seems to be easy, but it is not useful at many places, because we will be unable to create this kind of series. Here it was easy, we were able to create the series, but sometimes it is not so much easy to go from the base case till the upper edge. So then we will use backward substitution, which is useful in most of the cases. Let's see backward substitution next. Thank you.